hear a lot of people talk about, well, or maybe it don't anymore, in one sense. Well, our church don't have a standard. We don't do that thing. We don't have that kind of thing. We just don't believe, much like the televangelists, they don't want to lose listeners or whatever. But I have come to an understanding, at least in my own mind, that every church is going to have a standard. Every church is going to have a standard. The only question is whether or not that standard is set by the church or the world sets the standard for the church. Because even if you say you don't have one, then your standard becomes, by default, the world. Okay? And as the world trends downward, so will your standard and so will the church. So when Jesus said, would there be faith when the Son of Man comes by? Think about that. Okay. Where will the church be? And I don't know, okay, absolutely what the standard should be. I don't know. But I think we need to take some kind of stand. If it's just to say, we're not going to allow the world, as it trends downward and things become acceptable to them, okay? Mm-hmm. We won't allow them to become acceptable to us.
Right.
Otherwise, we follow them right down the same path. Okay? Mm-hmm. As things become more and more acceptable, my wife told me, that, I don't know, maybe I mentioned it before, right here in Charleston, there is a church that professes homosexuality. Okay. They have church services. And they claim they have great services. And I understand from someone who accidentally went there, supposedly it's apostolic. Okay. I don't know how you get that. Supposedly. They have good services, and they say that the Spirit of the Lord is being poured out. Something's not right. I can't see that. But that would have never been tolerated years ago.
That's right.
We have trended down as the world trends down. Okay, we accept everything coming and going. It's inevitable that it filters into the church if the church doesn't have some kind of standard of some sort for themselves. Now, they can come together, put their minds together, the English notion, okay? They have established for themselves a certain code to live by.
Right.
How did they do it? Well, they got together. They looked at what they believed the Word told them to do, okay? And that's kind of how they set these things for themselves to follow. Now,
yes.
You take the thing with faith, they have different sects, but most of them, or some of them, you know, they don't believe in modern automobiles, so that you see them in the buggies. Okay? Mm-hmm. So I don't know how they arrived at all that, but surely to goodness, the Word tells us, let us reason together. Let us reason together. Surely to goodness, we could come together and figure out something to kind of set a banner up there for the world to see, you know, that they would recognize that, yes, we do have something we're standing for Jesus on.
Yes.
Now, whether or not all of that is absolutely required for you to get to heaven, I don't know, okay? That's between you and God. But I think, you know, when I look back at the churches the way they were, the older saints, what they were, you know, how they looked, how they talked, their demeanor. And I look at us today and I see the difference in the power of God that moved then and what I see in church today, it's a big difference. Now, God didn't change. I have to place the blame on me. As the world trends down, I trend down, and the church trends down. So, if God tarries for very long, will he find any faith when he comes back? Where will we be at? Where will we and the church be at when he comes back? So I think that question is for us. And if not every day, certainly at least every once in a while, we should evaluate ourselves and ask God, Lord, how am I doing, Lord? You know, am I still trying to hold fast to the old path? You know, have I slacked up somewhere, Lord? Open my eyes. Help me to see that I might grow closer.
Jesus.
All right, I'm going to close there. But I'll leave you with that tonight.
My God.
Jesus. Every once in a while, take an evaluation of yourself. Yes. And as I mentioned last week, when thoughts come to anyone that's given the word, whether it be a teacher, evangelist, pastor, or even individuals, okay? I think it's given to them first for them to face. Because the husbandman must be first partaker to the fruit. So I've got to address what it exposes to myself first, okay? And then I share that, and then you have to address yourself. All right. Anybody have any comments or any questions you want to ask to us?
You know, the thing you hear so much on these TV programs supposed to be for evangelists is sow your seed. Huh. You know, send us $1,000, sow your seed.